Started UTA, had to get a job to make my way through, and started there as a part-time teller, and then became a full-time teller, and then became loan filer, and you know, did the whole deal all the way up to credit training at Nations Bank. We were bought out. My small bank was bought out by Nations Bank, and NCNB and all that, First Republic and all that stuff. And then I went to credit training in Dallas, and that's how I ended up getting commercial lending. I was working at Woodhaven Bank, already lived here, and I was down here making a call on a commercial prospect, ran into Roger Feigley, and Roger Feigley had told me that there was that the city owned a branch downtown that Southwest Bank was in, but they were moving to the Walmart. And I wanted to be a bank president in a smaller town where I could really be active. And so when he said there was a location available, then I went back to the president of Woodhaven and said, well, there's branches available. And we were able to fend off some other people and lease it from the city. And that's how it started. When we entered the market, there were five banks total, including Southwest, which was moving to the Walmart. And so it was only 27,000 people, but five banks for 27,000 people. I remember at the time looking and seeing South Lake and that whole area up there had like 19 banks for similar number of people. So it was really underbanked, pretty significantly underbanked. So it was a pretty easy decision. It was a really kind of a small community, and you went anywhere, most of the people there. I think banking's changed as a whole. The whole area's changed, but one thing that's really changed is whenever I first started calling on the industrial district out there, calling on any kind of business out here, they were usually owned by those people. I mean, all those businesses out there were owned by whoever started the business up and whenever they started it up. And over time, they've been bought out by national companies, by investment firms. The builders, we did a lot of builder business, and they were custom homes being built on the country club, and now it's builders that build 2,000 homes a year. Everything's gone really on a much bigger scale. The retail is mostly bigger scale. Even across the street here is Braces, and that's probably owned by something that's a much larger thing than just somebody that's an orthodontist. Everything is on a bigger scale. It's not as much the little sole proprietor, family-owned business like it was when we first came out here. Well, obviously there's a lot more. Every year, and every bank will tell you this, our teller transactions go down. And it's just because more and more people do it online, ATMs, on their phones. You get paid by, whenever I started banking back in 85, 86, I was a teller and I'd run myself more transactions than the whole bank does, and I did it in an afternoon because people would come cash your checks, and so you were just, it was constant and nonstop, four or five people on the line, you know, kind of thing. And so it's completely changed from that standpoint, is that the online banking, the electronic nature of banking has made it where there's a lot less paper out there, a lot less that type of transaction being handled. From the lending side, it's funny, I'd heard a long time ago at a deal I went to that, and it was a realtor event more than it was a banking event, but hey, bankers, y'all better watch out because online banking's coming and y'all won't be needed in 20 years, and this was 20 years ago, you know. So, but good news is I think people still want to be able to go to a place where they can feel like they know where their money is. So I think people still, when it comes to money, they still like to have personal relationships, and they still a little more touchy-feeling than just strictly online. You know, I've always really felt honored to be able to deal with the people I deal with. I mean, I'm getting to deal with people that took risks, that started their own business, that they had something in them that drove them and an overall knowledge to be able to be successful in what they're doing. And not many of us can do that. That's why I say bankers are always kind of wannabe entrepreneurs. We can kind of live vicariously by lending them the money, but we just don't have the nerve to do it. It's really too bad they get beat on so bad as being the 1%, the rich or whatnot, because they take all the risk. They are the people that make this country what it is. And as a banker, it's really, really interesting to be able to be able to get to know their businesses, to really get to know them, what makes them tick, you know, how they make money. We get the inside vision that most people don't know. And it's really interesting. It's been really a neat part of my job. And you know, that's what I think that I said in Rotary the other day, that to get a free banker, which is what we are, I mean, I'm an experienced banker and we have two other experienced bankers here and we've had others that have gone to be presidents of other branches. To get an experienced person for the same cost as it costs you to go and go to one of the big banks where they have a new person every 90 days, why wouldn't you take advantage of that? Why wouldn't you be able to come to me or to Clay or to Michelle, to Debbie, to Chuck, whoever, and say, okay, I'm thinking about doing this, Lance, what do you think about this? What would you do? Because I've seen a lot of these businesses over the years, and that's, some of that's good, some of that's bad, but it really, it's like having an attorney for free. It's like having a realtor for free. You might as well get an experienced banker if you're going to do things, because it didn't cost you anything. I say we have Walmart pricing and Macy's service. It is the people, and that's all it is. The products are the products. Does a Wells Fargo have probably a better online, better mobile? But they have better. It's not appreciably better. But what we have that's much, much better is that I have customers. I saw one in the bank today that I started doing business with him 21 years ago. And I hadn't seen him in 3 years because he's been doing other things. But I mean, I know my customers. I know what they've been through. Whereas it's hard to do that at a big bank because they have constant turnover. I've worked at a big bank before. I know it well. So if you can get somebody that knows your business when you come into the bank and they know you, it's just your advantage. And so that's really is our difference. And it's all the way down to the tellers, to our new accounts reps. Well, here it is. We know our customers. They walk in the bank. We know who they are. We treat them like we know who they are. So if they have to cash a check, we don't ring them through their, you know, you walk up to a counter of some of those banks, you're going to have to get your ID out every time. You're treated like a stranger every time. And here we're asking about your pet or whatever. Give them a dog bone. It's just a much different type of banking. And that's with us. We're really lucky because Pinnacle bought out Woodhaven 4 years ago. The Pinnacle's a family-owned business. The bank, even though it's a $12 billion bank, they let each of us operate autonomously, and they're family-owned. And the owner knows me, knows my wife, knows my kids. You know, so it's a situation where we can offer what all the big banks offer, but we act more like a small bank, which is really a nice blend. I do think it's important that you also choose a bank that gives back to the community and that people are volunteering in the community and are active in the community. There's a reason for helping those that can't help themselves. Pinnacle Bank not only tolerates me spending as many hours as we spend on Mansfield Cares or the chamber when I was chamber chairman or Rotary or whatever it is, they don't not only tolerate it, they expect it. They encourage it. They'll tell us at times, go give away money. That really fits in well with me because that's the other thing I love about the job is that we're kind of paid to do volunteer work and I enjoy volunteer work. So I think that it's important for people to try to figure out, and not only just banks, whatever it is, pick the businesses that are helping the rest of the community and do business with them. It makes for a stronger community that way.